Hi, and welcome back to the Gooligum Electronics PIC Tutorials. In this lesson, we'll set up the tools we need to get started with PIC development. As you recall from the last lesson, you'll need an IDE, a C compiler for the C lessons, a PC or laptop, a PIC programmer, and a dev board. We'll be using MPLABX, XC8, the PIC Kit 3 programmer, and the Gooligum PIC baseline training board in these tutorials. First, let's download and install MPLABX. Go to microchip.com and find the MPLABX section. When I made this video, it was under Software Tools in the Design Support section, but Microchip have been known to change the website around before, so you might have to go looking for it. Once you get to the MPLABX page, go to the Downloads tab and download the latest version for whichever platform you're using. Microchip releases new versions fairly often, so you almost certainly see a later version than the one you see here. As you've noticed, I'm using Windows. Please don't judge me. So if you're using Linux or a Mac, the installation will be a bit different. When the download is finished, and it might take a little longer than you see here, open the installer you've just downloaded. I'll close the web browser while the MPLABX installer is running. The installation process is pretty much just a case of hitting next, next, next. First, accept the license agreement. After reading it carefully, of course, you can just accept the default installation directory, unless you have some special reason to change it. When it comes to choosing what programs to install, you will definitely want MPLABX IDE. After all, that's why we're here. The other choice is MPLABIPE. It's a standalone program used for loading, or programming, executable code into a PIC. It could be code you've already developed, or code you got from someone else, that you may not have any source code for. We won't be using it in these tutorials, but it's a handy tool, so you might as well install it. And if you're feeling generous, you can send your info to Microchip. When the installation is complete, you might see this message about switching tools. But I think it only appears if you've already installed MPLAB 8, which is the old version of MPLAB. We won't be using MPLAB 8 in these tutorials, so you can safely ignore this message. Finally, the installer prompts you to go and download some components that plug into MPLABX. We'll want the XC8 compiler later for the C tutorials, and in later lessons we'll take a look at the code configurator. It's really useful. But we won't worry about them just yet. We'll download them later when we need them, so untick these boxes for now. Then click Finish to finish the installation. And now, time for some hardware. After all, we need to be able to program an actual PIC, sitting on a development board, connected to a PC or laptop. And, once again, I'll be using a Microchip PIC Kit 3 programmer with the Gooligum baseline PIC training board in these tutorials. First, plug the PIC Kit 3 into the ICSP connector on the training board with the arrows aligned. And then use a mini USB cable to connect the PIC Kit 3 to your PC or laptop. Finally, plug your PIC chip into one of the sockets on the training board. We'll be starting with a PIC 10F200, which goes into the 10F socket, with the notch at the end of the chip aligned with the notch at the top of the socket. You have to be careful here to use the correct PIC socket. If you're using a 12F or a 16F PIC, it should be plugged into the 12F-16F socket. In the next video, we'll download the tutorials and take a look at how the lessons are structured. Then we'll finally be ready to start programming PICs. See you then!